We want to use a decimal grid to shade a model for the fraction 2/5, then write the fraction as a decimal, and then write the fraction as a percentage. Let's begin by defining our decimal grid. The 10 by 10 grid, often called a flat, equals 1. The 1 by 10 grid, often called a long, equals 1/10. Notice 10 longs equals 1 flat, since 10 tenths equals 1. And the 1 by 1 grid, often called a bit, equals 1/100. Notice 10 bits equals 1 long, because 10 1/100ths equals 1/10. So going back to our example, even though our flat or 10 by 10 grid cuts or denominates one whole into 100 equal partitions, because our fraction has a denominator of 5, we'll cut or denominate our 10 by 10 grid into 5 equal partitions. So let's go ahead and cut or partition it here, 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 and here. And now because the numerator is 2, we want to counter enumerate 2 of these partitions, which means we'll shade 2 of the 5 partitions. Let's go ahead and shade these top 2. So the shaded region represents a model for 2/5 of one whole. Now we're asked to write the fraction as a decimal. To do this, we'll use 1 by 10 grids, or longs. Notice how the shaded region would consist of 1, 2, 3, 4 longs, where each long is equal to 1/10. So as a decimal, 2/5 is equal to 4/10, which would be 0.4. And now for the last part, we want to write the fraction as a percentage, where a percentage is a number per 100. So looking back at our model, let's focus on the 10 by 10 grid, which cuts or partitions 1 into 100 equal pieces. Notice when we focus on the 100 partitions, 40 of them are shaded, which means this represents 40%. 2/5 as a percentage equals 40%. So we've discovered that 2/5 is equivalent to or equal to 4/10, or 0.4 as a decimal, which is also equivalent to or equal to 40% as a percentage. I hope you found this helpful.